My name's Daniel Gordon. I'm a British documentary filmmaker. I've made three films in North Korea, beginning in 2002 with the documentary about called The Game of Their Lives, about the North Korean soccer team from the World Cup in 1966, the year that England won the only World Cup we've won so far in the history of World Cups. But to me, the most remarkable story of that year was the North Koreans. They came over, no one knew them, they were the enemy, we'd fought the Korean War against them. You know, and there was a lot of, you know, political stuff behind the scenes. They didn't want the flag flying because it would imply recognition of North Korea. And again, Britain didn't even recognize North Korea as a country. When I saw footage of them as a kid, you know, they looked funny. They had really funny names. The commentators couldn't even describe the names. There's a great commentary of one of the more respected soccer commentators in England. You know, was saying number two passes to number three and then to number four. He just didn't know their names. And that mystique lived with me from being a child. And when I got into documentary filmmaking, I knew that one of the films I wanted to make was about this team. In 1966, they emphatically lost their first game. They then drew, very fortunately tied their second game, and then they beat Italy, which was the best team in Europe, certainly possibly the world. They were probably the favourites in 66. The people first were very curious, and then they just got, you know, they got behind them, because the British love an underdog. It is remarkable that the people of Middlesbrough, you know, English, had fought on the American side against North Korea only 13 years earlier, and it was a brutal war, and yet the Cold War's going on, we're fighting communism, there's Reds under the beds, and yet they decide, for whatever reason, to lay all that politics aside, and they just got right behind them as if it was the local side. There was always an issue in the back of my mind: are we being used as propaganda for North Korea's propaganda tool? And I found actually that the North Koreans, once they knew that I wasn't there, you know, to pretend to make one film and actually go and make another, once they knew that this is the type of film that I wanted, a non-judgmental approach, once they knew all that and they figured it out, then they were totally trusting. And, you know, to the point where they've never seen our footage, you know, before it's left the country. I think the biggest misconception of North Korea is, well, you know, North Korea will hate the South Korean success and vice versa. But all Koreans that I've spoken to, North and South, have said, look, you just don't understand Korea. We are Koreans. You know, the fact that they're from South Korea doesn't matter. We celebrate their success as a Korean. And it'll be interesting to see if North has to play South for a place in the final, whether that's still the same. But, you know, I think it's remarkable that sport can unify to such a degree. And, you know, it's been 44 years since they've last competed at this level. So I think these guys are there to prove a point for their country. But I would be extremely surprised if any of the players know anything about what's going on politically inside North Korea, or the way that everyone's reacting. You know, at the moment, that the big issue is, you know, the sinking of the South Korean naval vessel. I'd be surprised if the North Korean players know anything about it, or if they do, they're only going to know their own side of it, you know, what the official media has fed them, which won't be that much. And, you know, they're interested purely in soccer. That's what they've been training all this time to do, and they're extremely proud. They want to go and do their very, very best for their country. And that's what they'll be focused on. They won't get sidetracked on any of the politics, and, you know, they'll just be focused on soccer. And it was exactly the same in 1966. You know, football, you know, was actually all about promoting peace. And it's true, and it sounds a bit, it can sound trite, but football can do so much more than politicians can ever do.
Scored their first goal of the World Cup tournament.